Hey everybody, welcome back to a new video. In today's video, I'll be showing you how easy it is to add extra solar panels to your trailer or RV. Now this is actually my dad's motorhome. He already has a few solar panels installed on the roof. Sometimes the panels on the roof are shaded from trees or the weather isn't the best, so he's wanting additional solar panels to deploy on the ground for more power. So whether your RV or trailer already has solar panels or you don't have any solar panels at all, the purpose of this video is to show you how easy it is to install extra solar panels that you can deploy on the ground. Stay tuned, we're gonna jump right into it. So these are the components laid out that my dad has chosen to go with for his solar install. First is the X-Star SP150. This is a 200 watt class folding solar panel. Next is the Renogy Voyager 20 amp charge controller with 2 feet of 8-gauge wire and a 40 amp resettable fuse. So we've decided that the best place to install the charge controller is here in the battery compartment for the RV. So inside this compartment, he has three 100 amp hour battle-borne batteries connected in parallel, just the 12 volt batteries. And we think that mounting the charge controller and fuse will be really good on this metal panel on the side. And then we'll tie that into the batteries and we'll have a pigtail hanging off so that you can connect up the solar panel. Now up on the screen, you'll see a simple wiring diagram for this setup. I just wanted to lay everything out so you can see how simple it is to install everything. Now I will include all the links to the parts that I used down in the video description. Now remember, this is for a 200 watt panel. If you wanted to add other panels or additional panels, you may have to upgrade some of the components, but I am available through a consulting service called Ask Me. I'll include the link to that down in the video description. So we're gonna go ahead and get started installing these components and we'll let you know what it looks like after we're done. So we were able to get the holes drilled for the solar charge controller. We started with a punch and then drilled those out. And then we also got the holes drilled for the fuse. So now we just have to deal with connecting these up and then connecting them to the battery. When it comes to making custom cables, I like to use these hydraulic crimpers for the larger gauge wire, and I use standard ratcheting crimpers for the smaller gauge wire. Now these give a really good result, especially for being a budget crimper off Amazon. And then after this is done, all you do is heat shrink it up with a heat gun and you're good to go. So the next step is connecting all the wires up to your charge controller so we can mount it on the wall. So here's a breakdown of what's going on. So we have two wires for the battery, positive and negative, and we have two wires for the solar input, positive and negative. You can see the connections here. These are 1/4 inch terminals, and I crimped these wires in and then used heat shrink and tighten these down. So we are using 8-gauge wire to the battery for the output and 12-gauge wire for the solar input. So now we can just slide this cover up and over and then mount this to the wall. Okay, so we have everything wired up. I thought I'd give you guys just a quick tour to show you how everything's connected. So up here we have the charge controller showing 14.5 volts and I did set this to the lithium setting. So there are two main connections. We have the connections going to the battery and the connections for the solar. So let's go over the battery connections first. So 8-gauge wire coming off the charge controller. The positive has this switchable fuse. And then the negative is just zip tied to that. They both go over here to the negative and the positive terminal of the battery. So very simple connections there. We just wanted to go with 8-gauge wire just so we didn't have any voltage drop. And if we ever wanted to upgrade this to a larger controller in the future, we wouldn't have to worry about changing that out. So this is rated at 20 amps and this wire is rated for 40 amps continuous. So that's the battery. Now, whenever this is not in use, we just turn this off from the switch there so it doesn't have any drain on the battery. And then whenever he's gonna use the solar panel, he'll just flip that on and then the charge controller turns on. Now for solar, it's very easy. You just have the two pigtails coming off. Now we've opted to go with XT60 just so it's easy to connect up with his solar panel that he has. There is a 20 amp inline fuse on this 12 gauge wire, so it's good for 20 amps. But that's how everything's connected up. So now that everything's hooked up in here, I thought I'd show you how easy it is to connect up the solar panel. So he's opted to go with this solar panel I talked about earlier. This is the X-Star SP150. It's a 200 watt solar panel. They've just downrated the wattage so that it performs really well on paper, right? So now this solar panel has MC4 connections that come off of it. And then I have a 30 foot 12 gauge extension cable that has XT60. And all you'd have to do is connect that straight up to the XT60 coming off the charge controller. And then this solar panel is good to go. Now, he likes the folding solar panel because he can stow it away in one of these storage areas. I mean, just think doesn't take up much space at all. And You know, you can still get the 200 watts, but say you were in more of a permanent, you know, parking solution and you wanted to have some solar panels on the ground in a more permanent location, I'd recommend going with a glass rigid panel. They're actually more affordable and more durable. So you don't have to use a folding solar panel. You can go with a glass rigid panel. But, you know, hopefully you guys found this video helpful. It's super easy to connect up everything. If you are looking for a little bit of advice or consulting on which type of solar panel or which charge controller you can go with, I do have the Ask Me service, the consulting service that I've started. So I'll leave the link to that down in the video description so you guys can reach out. But I'd be happy to, you know, provide some basic information on how, you know, what charge controller, what solar panel, what type of wiring, everything like that. But super easy install. He's excited to be able to use the solar panel to supplement what he already has on the roof. It's getting dark here, so I'm going to end the video. Thanks, guys, for watching. If you like the video, please smash the thumbs up button. I'll recommend a couple other videos you can check out. We'll see you guys in the next one.